Testing, 1, 2, 3. All right, so I know it works. It's January. It will soon be another weekend, and the first week of January, and the first week of the year will be over. How time flies when we're having fun. Psychobabble here on Vloasis, and this is a video for Vloasis. I'm gonna leave it on link only. On YouTube for a while at least. I hope I remember to shut off the damn ads. Psychobabble gave me a challenge of sorts on his comment to respond to my comment on Josiah's piece about our village idiot, Phantom Vision, banished now forevermore, quoth the Franklin, nevermore. Well, I just broke the first thing by using poetic bullshit instead of just turning on the camera and talking like a normal person. Well, I'm not a normal person. I'm abnormal. Most of us vloggers are abnormal in one way or another. Or we talk to our friends and our family instead of reaching out across the ethers, beyond and beyond and beyond, through all the wiggly through the tubes. Through the tubes. My camera's over there, so I look over at the camera and then I look back at the screen and I look over. And if I could just talk like a normal person, I can't. I can't talk like a normal person. I'm too bent. And one of the great Christian writers of the 20th century was a man named C.S. Lewis. And he wrote some science fiction novels. The first one, Out of the Silent Planet, is about a trip to Mars, and then there's Perelandra, which is a trip to Venus, and it's all just a big Christian allegory. And this man from Earth, the silent planet is Earth because the great spirit that ruled the planet Earth fell into darkness. Read Satan. And that's sort of part of the Gnostic theory, too. There's an underlayer to Christianity of Gnosticism, which has been stomped on over and over again by the heavy boots of Orthodox Christianity because of some of the things that Gnosticism preaches, such as the God of the Earth is Satan, and the real God, the Father, the Great Spirit, is out there in the ethers, and he can never get through the wall of Satan, which is bullshit. I am scientific, and I believe, as the Declaration of Independence says, I believe in nature and nature's God. That's exactly what it says in the Declaration of Independence. Because it was written by a freaking humanist, secular liberal named Thomas Jefferson, who owned slaves. We people are not normal. We're bent. Now, in the book, Out of the Silent Planet, which is Earth, because it's not in contact with the astral spheres anymore, this man, the narrator, went to Mars with a bunch of bad people who wanted to corrupt Mars and steal their whatever. And Mars, the people were so pure and so in contact with spiritual reality that they didn't have a word for lies. They didn't lie. They exaggerated, and they did this and that for the sake of beauty, but they didn't do evil lies. Evil lies. Fake DMCs. So, the poor little divine, holy creatures of Mars, they were these hippopotamus people who lived in the water, and then there were these skeleton people who lived up on the cliffs where the air was so thin that hardly anyone could breathe, and then there were the angels who were everywhere, and the great angel, the ethereal spiritual lord of the planet, who often flew up into space to talk to the other lords of the other planets, except for Earth, because Earth was fallen. Well, these lovely little sacred worshipping people, well, they weren't people, creatures on Mars, thinking creatures, there were several races of them, they didn't have a word for lies or bad or evil or wicked. The closest they could get to it, if something was bent. And there's an interesting scene when the bad people from Earth are talking with the great spirit, which they have trouble seeing, and they're complaining about this other guy from Earth who they kidnapped and brought to Mars, who's actually kind of a good guy. He's a university professor. Surprise, surprise. The author, C.S. Lewis, was one of those academics who wrote lovely little Christian novels. Well, actually, he wrote some pretty hot shit. But he was an academic, along with the author of The Lord of the Rings, J.R.R. Tolkien. They were friends, in fact. Just like senators. My friend from California. My friend from Arkansas. The gentleman, the lady from New York, Hillary Clinton. Excuse me. Anyhow, I'm not normal, psychobabble. I'm not normal. I just turned on the camera and I just talked right now and you saw what came out of my mouth. Literary references and blah, 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 blah. I'm not even a normal academic. I am such a bent poet. I don't follow the rules, except there are rules for people like me who break the rules. Every kind of humanity has its archetype. And I'm not the first one. Everybody, some of them are more bent than I am. Like Allen Ginsberg. He was way more bent than I am. And maybe that's why he was a much greater poet than I am. Anyhow, yes, this is my old room here. I'm out in what used to be the garage. We now have the washing and drying machine right over there. That's where I do all the laundry. It's about time to start cleaning up after Christmas. Got to do all the laundry we put off for a week or two while we were getting ready for the party and all that stuff. My stepsister and her daughter came over yesterday with the two little baby boys. One is 3 and the other is almost 1. Oh, man, life goes on. They are such young, young children with so many years in front of them. I would be grateful to God if I could see them grow up a little bit. Like I've watched my niece and her brother, my nephew, grow up. When they were born, about the same time my son was born. My son is going to be here. In February, he's coming back from New York City with his girlfriend. And everybody's all excited. We're going to meet her. We're going to meet her. We're going to meet her. Yeah. Now, that's kind of normal. That came out kind of normal. My stepsister and her daughter, my niece, and their two children are over yesterday, and in another couple months, my son is going to be here from New York, and blah, blah, blah. That's not bent at all. It's perfectly straightforward. So there. I said something. I better stop before I get in trouble again. Bye. And thank you, Shawny, for slapping him up the side of the head.